So I thought I would share David's true Hollywood stories. Dun dun. Our true DoorDash stories, I guess, right?
D's true Hollywood. I mean, DoorDash stories.
Hey, what's up, guys? David from Team Rubalcaba Network, and just checking in to share with you guys. So I come home, in case you guys don't know, I do a DoorDash on the side right now, you know, for some extra income or whatever. But sometimes I come home with some strange stories and stuff that my wife always asks me, you know, how did it go and all that kind of stuff. So I know that a lot of people are curious about what it's like to be out there, and do you ever come across some weird things? Do you ever come across weird people and just kind of strange situations? So I thought I would share David's true Hollywood stories. Dun dun. Our true DoorDash stories, I guess, right? And so I have a couple of things that, you know what, honestly, I saw some pretty cool stuff. I've seen some weird stuff. And I've also seen acts of kindness that were unexpected too, through the use of DoorDash, which is crazy. So I'll share some of those stories with you guys. So that's my little one. He's asleep right now. We're actually waiting for one of our boys to get out of school right now. So I just figured, you know, what the heck, I might as well record something, right? So I've kind of rarely dealt with some things that made me feel uncomfortable. For the most part, DoorDash is really cool. People are happy. Like I said before, they like high five you. They're excited. They got their food. Everyone's happy. I get there, the kids are like screaming because they're happy and stuff. Like, I'm not exaggerating. Like, people are really happy. But there was this one time a couple weeks ago where I decided, you know, I got to do this order. It's kind of almost towards the end of my shift too, because I usually do, you know, a couple hours here and there. Some days I'll have like a full day, you know, when I'm off or whatever. So but I picked up this last order. It was actually pretty close. It wasn't too far out of the way. And you know, I picked up the order, took it, nothing unusual. But as I got to the house, you know, I got to the house, ring the doorbell, and you know, there's dogs barking and whatever. Dogs don't bother me, you know, whatever. I hear the dogs barking, and this gentleman comes to the door. Now, I'm not gonna exaggerate this, because it kind of, for a second, I had to check myself, like, because I reacted. I think I went, whoa, or I did something where I was just like, oh man, I probably shouldn't have said that. But this gentleman came to the door, and I'm not exaggerating. He was a big fellow, man. I gotta say, maybe like 400 plus pound. I mean, he's pretty big guy. There's nothing wrong with that. But if you know that you put in a delivery and somebody's coming to pick up or deliver your order for you, you know, maybe, I don't know, maybe you might want to put some clothes on. So as I get to the door, this guy is literally walking to the door in his underwear. No shirt, no nothing, no pants, no underwear, whatever. And it was probably one of the most awkward things that I've probably experienced, because I was just like, here you go, have a good day, thank you. And you know, the guy just slammed the door in my face after I gave him his food. And I was just like, that's kind of weird, man. I've never had anything, you know, up until that point, anything weird like that. But I'm just saying, man, if you're gonna pick up a delivery, or you're expecting a delivery, I'm sorry, if you're expecting someone to deliver some food, you may want to put some clothes on. I don't know, but hey, I guess to each his own. So now this other story, this one, like, I have never ever been asked to go into somebody's house. So, and I pretty much don't want to do that. And you know, it's just kind of weird. I just kind of feel like you never know what people are gonna do. You know, I've heard some stories about people getting attacked or whatever from DoorDash. So, you know, and I'm usually pretty guarded. I'm on high alert all the time, you know, because I always, I guess, expect the worst out of people. I don't know, maybe that's what it is. But so I'm always on alert. And but this one time I got asked to come in, and I didn't really want to do it, but I felt bad, because the lady was probably in maybe her like mid 70s. She had a cane, she could barely walk and things like that. So I was like, you know, I'm gonna help her, I'll be helpful, you know, I don't care. And so I give her the bag or whatever, and then she had a bag, and I had drinks too, like two or three drinks in a holder. And so I'm like, I just asked her, you know, would you like for me to bring these in for you? And she said yes. And I was like, okay. So I come in and I'm like, where do you want me to put these? And she said, just go ahead and put it on the TV tray over there. And I was like, okay. And the moment I walked in, I was like, what the hell? I looked around and I was just like, what the hell? There was so much stuff. So much stuff. Have you guys ever seen that show, Hoarders? That's kind of like what it was like. It was almost uncomfortable. Hey, look, there's a police officer that just passed by in the background. Uh-oh. Hope I'm not parked in the red zone. Just kidding. I think I am. But hey, so I came in and I was just like, what the hell? And I literally had to like climb over stuff. And it was kind of weird. I thought I was going to slip and fall because there was so much stuff. Not only was there, it looked like there was kids' toys all around the TV, but there was just stuff all over the place. Like old newspapers, like exactly what you would think or what you see in Hoarders. You know, the series is exactly what I walked into. And the lady was super sweet, super nice or whatever. And so I gave her a food. She gave me a cash tip, which was awesome. So I told her, thank you so much. And I walked out of there and I was just like, man, I thought my kids and my wife were bad at hoarding, because they do, trust me. They never want to let go of anything, especially this one. Don't want to let go of any toy that he has. That thing's like overflowing everywhere. But man, I walked out of there like, holy crap, I guess we're not so bad at keeping stuff. But it was really bad, where it just made me uncomfortable. So, but like I said, she was really nice. But that was the first time that I walked into somebody, probably the last time I'll ever walk into someone's house. And it was just kind of weird. But there was this one day, I remember, you know, I pack lunches sometimes and all that stuff, you know, to try to save some money. And there was this one time where it was just like a long day. It was one of the days that I drove like all day, not 4 or 5 hours. It was an all day thing. So I think I drove for like 10 hours, whatever. It was a long day. And I, you know, towards the end of the night, and I was hungry, and I'm like, no, I don't want to spend any money. But I was like super, super hungry. And, you know, just imagine if you're starving and all you're doing is picking up food and all that stuff. It's kind of like, it sucks. It's like, you know, it's just tough to deal with sometimes. And, but you know, I was hungry. I'm like, I just got like an hour left. I just got to get home. I'll eat when I get home. It'll be fine. And I decided to pick up this last order before I went home, and it was from Red Robin.
Red Robin.
Yum. Right? It's Red Robin, right? The burger place. And so I was like, okay, cool. I'll get this one. And I went to pick it up, and something really cool happened. So if you've ever dashed, you'll understand what this is about. So I went in, picked up the order, and I'm checking the order, whatever, and then she gives me some fries. She's like, here you go, some fries. And I was like, I'm looking at the order, I'm like, I don't see fries on here. She's like, oh, this isn't for them, this is for you. And I was like, for me? What do you mean? And she's like, here's some fries, you know, thank you, here you go, have a good night. And I remember walking out that night of Red Robin. I was like, first of all, that's cool as hell that they take care of us. We're just going in and picking up stuff and dropping it off, right? We're not doing anything special. At least I don't think we are. But to give us something just to say thank you or whatever, I thought that was awesome. But the simple fact that I was starving that night, that was really cool, because I ate my fries. I was all happy, eating my fries, like, dude, I love this job. You know, and but it was pretty cool. It was a pretty cool thing for Red Robin to do. And from then on, I think that I look at them in even higher regard, because they didn't have to do that. And the funny thing is, that's happened to me multiple times, where it's at the end of the night and then I see Red Robin. I'm like, hell yes, Red Robin, because I'm gonna get free fries. And one of the nights it happened where I just started eating well, starting to work out a little bit more again, and then what comes up? Red Robin. I'm like, oh, I guess I'll start tomorrow, because I ate those damn fries because I was hungry. So this is, you know, something just kind of cool that happened. So I always love going to Red Robin, always get free fries. So I'll share one last one for you guys that I thought was pretty, it was pretty cool. At the time, I was like really confused as hell, and I'll explain why, because I just couldn't find where I needed to go. But so I got this order. It was for, I don't know, some like burger, fries, whatever. So I picked it up. I took it to this liquor store, which isn't uncommon. Like, I've delivered to some crazy places. We'll probably share that in another episode, but I've delivered to some really crazy places. And I was like, hey, it's just a liquor store. I'm like, whatever. So then I walk in with the food, and I don't remember what the name was, but I asked for, it was a girl's name, and I was like, oh, you know, this is for so-and-so. And the guy in the liquor store got really mad. He's like, you know, I don't know what's wrong with you guys. You guys keep delivering stuff here. I don't order no food. Don't like get. He basically told me get out, and I was like, okay, well, I don't know. This is the address that they gave, so I'm just coming in and I'll just, you know, whatever. So I'm like, I don't know what to do. So then I'm even thinking maybe I got the wrong place. Maybe it's the one next door. But I'm looking at the address, and the address says something, right? And then I decide to look at the notes, because I'm like, sometimes there's notes in there that'll say, hey, leave it here, or I'll be waiting here, or call me and I'll come out, you know, stuff like that. So I check the notes, and the notes literally say something like, leave by payphone. And I was all, leave by payphone? What the hell? So then I walk outside, I'm like, where the hell's the payphone? So the payphone's like maybe 20 feet away on the left-hand side. So I walk over there and I'm like, what the hell? Leave on payphone. So I just decided, you know what? I'm just gonna call the guy, because I'm not gonna just leave food here and then someone take off with it, right? And so I call the guy and I said, hey man, I'm here. The liquor store says I didn't order anything, and they basically kicked me out. I said, I don't know where you're at. You know, you in the parking lot, whatever. And he said, no, look for the woman that's sitting there, the homeless woman. And I'm like, the homeless woman? So I'm like looking around. So I don't see anybody at first. I'm looking around. I said, I don't see anybody. He's like, no, she's there. I just saw her. She's there. And I said, okay. So I just kept him on the phone. I said, okay, let me check for her. Let me look for her. And so I look to my right, and there's a tree there. And then I look down, and there's a lady sitting there. The lady, you know, she has all her stuff, has her cart, all that other stuff. And I say, you know what, I think I found her. And he's like, that's for her. And I was like, you mean you ordered food to deliver to her? And he's like, yeah, I did. And I said, okay. So I hung up, and I walked over with the food, and I said, hi, you know, my name's David, you know, from DoorDash. I have this order for you. And she just looks up at me, and I say, so here's your burger, and then here's a shake. Came with the shake, right? Because that's what he ordered. And the lady just lost it, you know, starts crying and all that stuff. So at this moment, I'm like, I don't even know how to react to what's happening, because I'm like, what the hell? So it didn't register yet what had happened. So I give her the food, I said, enjoy. And she's like, thank you. She was happy, she felt excited, whatever. And I walk away, and I sit down in my car, and I'm like, what the hell just happened right now? So it still didn't register yet. And I'm like, that was like really weird. And then it dawned on me that this man had used DoorDash to actually order food to deliver to someone in need, which I thought was super, super cool, because, you know, who does that kind of stuff, man? Like, if anything that's happening right now in the news and all this other stuff, it's like the simple acts of kindness to humanity. You just don't see it. And so to use DoorDash as a tool to do that, I thought was pretty cool. So it was actually really humbling. And I realized after that day that I'm like, man, there's still some good out in the world. And it was a reminder. And I came home and I was a little more grateful for what I do have, and grateful for my family. But it's amazing how you can use technology to really help somebody. All right, guys, so I hope you enjoyed David's true Hollywood, I mean DoorDash stories, man. So I gotta go pick up my son right now. He's getting out of school. But yeah, more to come, man. I think I have so many stories of just kind of random stuff that happens while you're out. And but like I said, I really enjoy doing it, kind of doing it on the side, and it's been a lot of fun. And I get to listen to my radio, bring my laptop, do a lot of work too while I'm out dashing. But it's actually been pretty fun. I'm not gonna lie, there's been some rough days, and then there's some amazing days, but always interesting. Every day is completely different. I meet new people every day. I'm looking forward to share more and more stories as it happens. But I appreciate you guys staying tuned. Stay tuned, listen to things that are going on the channel, new videos, all that fun stuff, and following our family journey, man. You never know what the next video is going to be, because we just kind of put out whatever we put out. Let's help us get to that 1,000. We're trying to get to that 1,000 subscribers. But I appreciate you guys' support. Stay tuned for more true DoorDash stories. So what's up, guys? So hey, yesterday I recorded these true DoorDash stories, so I just wanted to give you an update. Today, the very next day after I recorded them, the same man that didn't wear a shirt, very first order of the day. I am not making this up. I'm dead serious. I don't know if that's karma telling me that I probably shouldn't have recorded that piece, but I'm like, come on, bro, put on a damn shirt, dude. Like, I don't know. So today, I swear, I couldn't have planned that out. Today, same exact guy, no shirt, got delivered. So what can I say, man? It's true DoorDash stories, man. You can't make this kind of stuff up. So hoping to share more with you guys.
D's True Hollywood. DoorDash Stories.